using this fruit fly traps. Tracks should be opened only in the orchard itself. At the wooden piece is wrapped in polyfilm. So when we have to use, we have to open. Otherwise, the smell will go out if we open before placing it on the trees or our fruit plants. So traps should be fixed in shady areas. Remove the dead fruit flies from trap when 75% trap is filled to maintain its efficiency. So the collected dry flies, fruit flies, must be dug in the pit and buried in the pit. So adopt proper sanitation practices in the orchard or your kitchen garden where you have placed this fruit fly trap. Bury the infested fruits too deep in the soil. This is very important. If we don't bury the, we remain that fruits in the orchard, that will hibernate, and again the cycle will come, the fruit life cycle, they continue, and this infestation doesn't stop, and again the your orchard will become infested with fruit flies. This fruit fly trap is effective only for fruit crops. For vegetable, it is different lure. So we will discuss later on that also. This should be kept away from children's. These are some precautions. So when we see the there is less effectiveness in this, what are the conditions fixed when infestation on fruits already started? We have to fix them before ripening of fruits. If we place them when there is infestation, the effectiveness will be less. So if fixed in kitchen garden instead of orchard, if fixed late or early than the recommended time we discussed earlier, if fixed in less number than recommended, that is 16 number per acre or one trap after 9 to 10 plants, if vegetable are intercropped in the orchard, sanitation practices are not followed properly, then the effectiveness get deteriorated. So availability of PAU fruit fly traps, these are available from room number 19, Department of Fruit Science, PAU, Ludhiana, or you can get from your near KVK. In Pathankot, there is KVK. In every district, there is Krishi Vigyan Kendra. So farm dairy services, or regional substation, fruit substation of PAU Ludhiana and Department of Horticulture, so Office of Deputy Director or HDO of your area, you can dare, or from our citrus estates, we also prepare this fruit fly trap and provide to the farmers or individuals for this control of fruit flies. So cost is 118 rupees per trap. So this is recommended by ICAR on fruits. Termites, these are another, we can in Punjabi we say siyonk. This is also called white ants. These are very problematic in every area. So these are social, highly polyphagous, polymorphic, soil dwelling insects living in Terminatarium. Workers feed on roots by making gallery. You can see when we dig the infested area, we see the galleries and halophobic in nature. So they have fear of sun and hibernate in the soil, in the shady, in the down in the soil. Queen termite egg laying machine, very high egg laying is a termite queen is very high egg laying insect. So common termite species are Rambur and Microtermes species. Peak activity period of termites is April to June and September to October. Insecticides are effective only few days after application. These creates problem in all trees, all fruit plants, but mostly much is in pear, bear, peach, grapes, amla and mango. These are termites affect these plants most than others. So this is termite trap which has developed by PAU. So this is earthen pot with holes in that, and a maize cover placed in that. So this is the collected termite in this pot. We will see how it works. In next slide, we will see how to manage termite traps. So termite trap, as is shown in first figure, termite trap filled with maize cob without grains. So this is filled. And termite work, this is buried in the field 1 to 1.5 feet down, and upper lid is given on this pot, earthen pot filled with maize cobs. Termite worker feeding in empty maize cob get converted into soil material by termites. In third slide, you can clearly see how termite has collected in the that earthen pot within 20 to 25 days. So preparation and install, how these termite traps are used in orchards. Earthen pots 13 inch diameter with 24 holes, 16 holes on top top neck, and 8 holes all over in that earthen pot. Fill with maize cob without grains, that is in local language it is called gull or gulle. So 14 traps per acre are buried 8 to 2 feet deep with neck outside soil surface. Timing for this is very crucial, where when we use, when we these buried these earthen pots in soil, this is first week of April and first week of September. So twice in a year these earthen pots can be used. Termites get attracted within 3 days, and after about 20 days of installation, the trap hello yes main to dassya dassi main slide to kar reha si nahi hodi share kadon di dekho te dassya ne sir mainu udon dass dinde main te ਮਾਦੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਸਰ ਮੈਂ ਤੇ ਕਰ ਲੈਟ ਮੈਂ ਕਰਦਾ ਜੀ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਕਲੀਅਰ ਕਰਿਓ ਕਰੀ ਹਾਂ ਜਦੋਂ ਆ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਹੈ ਸੋ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਸਮ ਪ੍ਰੋਬਲਮ ਨੋਬਡੀ ਟੋਲਡ ਮੀ ਦੈਟ ਐਜ਼ ਆਈ ਵਾਸ ਸ਼ੇਅਰਿੰਗ ਫਰੋਮ from my slide, sorry for interruption. Can you tell me, anybody, that from where we have not seen the slides? Hello, Andy. Yes, slide di aa rahi. Ek minute ji, main sir, sorry, I will try my.
हेलो
हेलो
हां जी सर सशिकाल जी सर स्टार्टिंग तो ही नहीं शो हो रही
दसया नहीं फिर तुसी जी मैं ते अब ले लो शुरू कर लिए फिर
इथो ही बेशक शेयर कर लो
राइट ठीक है जी ओके टर्माइट तो ठीक
है पहला क्लियर ही हैगा सारे नु आए थे
अच्छा ठीक है मैं टर्माइट तो कर दे देख ली
है ओके सर
राइट चलो सो सॉरी फॉर इंटरप्शन आफ्टर फ्रूट फ्लाई ट्रैप्स इज इट क्लियर टू एवरीबॉडी
Yes, sir.
Hanji, sir.
Yes, this is one slide you can see. For nutshell, fruit fly traps can be in plum. It is a second week of April. They can be placed on the plants. For peaches, it is now very peak time, prime time to use these traps. First week of May. In mango, third week of May, you can place these traps. In pear, it is first week of June. For guava, it is first week of July. Rather, I can say it is mid of June. In mid of June, you can place these traps for guava. And in citrus, or you can say this kino, second week of August is a prime time. 16 traps can be used for this. So this after 30 days, effectiveness is less, and lure can be changed again. So some precautions we have already discussed. So I come to termites. This is we say white ants or siyok in Punjabi. These are also very dangerous insect creators on earth. So these are also called white ants, social, highly polyphagous, polymorphic, soil-dwelling insect living in termitarium. Worker feed on roots by making galleries. Heliphobic, queen termites, egg-laying machine, very fastly lays egg. Common termite species are rambur and microtermis species. Peak activity period for this is April to June and September to October. So insecticides are effective for only few days after application. So these create problem in very all the fruit plants. This is the termite trap designed by PAU. This is an earthen pot of 13 inch, 16 holes are placed on neck and 8 holes on other below this, and this is filled with how to manage the trap. Termite trap filled with maize cob without grain. This is placed in the earthen pot with the holes, 24 holes, and termite workers start feeding in the empty maize cob, and maize cob get converted into soil material by termites. You can see in third photo in the same slide. So how to prepare and install these termite traps in the orchard? Earthen pots of 13 inches diameter with 24 holes, 16 on top below neck, plus 8 on all over the earthen pot. The pot is filled with maize cob without grain, which we in Punjabi say gul or gulle. So 14 trap per acre are buried day to 2 feet deep with neck outside soil surface. So timing for placing these termite traps is April, first week of April and first week of September. Termites get attracted within 3 days. So killing the termites, when the termites are trapped in that pot, so after 20 days installing the trap, dip the earthen pots with lack of termites trapped inside into water having few drop of diesel. So in water you can put diesel and place the pot as it has holes, and this kill the termite which we have collected in the on the maize cob. So benefits of traps: eco-friendly and cheaper, has no pesticide residue in soil, fruit plants, environment, no repeated application as in insecticides, mass trapping of termites, thousand to lakh of termites can be trapped in a single trap, in single pot, easily fit in IPM, integrated pest management program. Trap can be used again and again, so only you have to fill it with sorry, let's with cobs and place again. So the cost of termite trap is 70-90, but 14 such traps cost about 1000 to 1200 rupees per acre. So same the as we saw, we can prepare ourselves also. But if we have, there is nothing, because nothing doctor says in that that you can purchase it for 70-90 from PAU Ludhiana or their KVK and other offices. But you can prepare it itself, as it's only 13-inch earthen pot with a drill. You can put the holes on that and only fill the cob. F5, shift F5 ke only F5, is it okay? No, I think nahi hua. Ha, maine to fully ki thi. So another device is other mechanical devices. Chafer beetle is another insect which is very harmful. So PAU chafer beetle trap is can be used to control this chafer beetle. This damaged adult beetle are seen in orchard in month of May-June. Beetle appear soon after dusk and feed on leaves. On hatching, grubs usually feed on rootlets of various grasses and other organic matter available in the soil, and even on the roots of some fruit crops. Grubs are igni-bite, fleshy and curved C-shaped. Adults feed on leaves, making number of holes. This is the damage they do. In case of severe infestation, entire leaf lamina may be eaten away and entire tree may be defoliated, which leads to lack of chlorophyll and fruit is found on that plant. Damage more in sandy and sandy loam soils. Pupae and adult hibernate in soil from November to April. The only one generation per year is. This is, you can see the damage with adult beetle. All the leaves.
So sorry for interruption, sir. Yes. Ajay, we slide pehli hi show ho rahi hai. How to manage? Oh. Agliya show nahi ho rahi hai. First slide pe apa baithe hain Ajay.
Acha.
Haan ji, change nahi ho rahi hai.
I don't know what is.
Jee, tu se pehli show kar rahe ho. How to manage white trap? Ek hi show ho rahi hai.
Acha. Aage aayi thi ji. Aage.
Nahi hoya nahi. Aage change nahi ho rahi hai. First thing hai.
Second macron.
Okay, sir.
Slide kani aage ja rahi, keh rahe ho unde slide nahi aage ja rahi. Ha te itto hi aage ja rahi hai, main bahut aage ja.
हां जी सर, हुन हो रही है चेंज। preparation and installation of termite traps in the orchards.
Right,
sir. Yes, sir. Okay.
Hello.
Yes.
हाँ जी सर, इनो स्लाइड शो भी कर लो काइंडली, वो विजिबल नहीं हो रहा ज्यादा लाइक।
करिए स्लाइड शो, करिए स्लाइड शो। ये जो है इसपे
जी सर, मेरे स्क्रीन पे ही आ रहा है जो
ये आ रही है।
ठीक है जी,
मनप्रीत आप वहां जूम कर सकते हैं।
डॉक्टर साहब कंट्रोल
ठीक है जी।
ओके
डॉक्टर साहब, कंट्रोल F5 नाप के दे स्लाइड शो हो जाएगा जितना मैडम कह रही है।
कीता जी अगे ऑलरेडी कीता जी।
ठीक है ठीक,
हां जी। इस नाउ इस आप ये जो चैफर बीटल थे जी, व्यू हो रहा है
सर? सर अपा है गए हैं प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एंड इंस्टॉलेशन ऑफ टर्माइट ट्रैप्स इन द ऑर्चर्ड्स, वही स्लाइड शो हो रही है अपनी। ओके जल्दी है, अगे नहीं हो रही, हुन भी उतनी ही है।
अच्छा जी, सटे दे
सर।
सिंगल ही कर रहे
नहीं
हो रही है जी, तो चलो फिर ओके, सो अपन टर्माइट, वी कैन टॉक अबाउट द टर्माइट ट्रैप्स। सो वी आर ऑन दिस पीएयू केफर बीटल ट्रैप।
यस यस,
सो व्हेन वी टॉक, वी आर टॉक अबाउट द केफर बीटल इंसेक्ट्स, द एडल्ट बीटल आर सीन इन ऑर्चर्ड। व्हाट डैमेज दे डू द डैमेज इन मे और जून। बीटल्स अपीयर सून आफ्टर डस्क एंड फीड ऑन लीव्स। ऑन हैचिंग ग्रब्स usually feed on rootlets of various grasses and other organic matter available in soil and even on roots of some fruit crops. So the grubs are dignified, fleshy and curved C-shaped. Other feed on leaves, making number of holes. In case of severe infestation, entire leaf lamina may be eaten away by, and entire tree may be defoliated, which leads to chlorophyll, and the plants, they don't bear any fruits. Lack of chlorophyll, they don't bear any fruits. So damage within sandy and sandy loam soil. Hibernate in soil from November to February. So only one generation per year is the damage. This is the adult beetle, the damage done on the grape vines. You can see how they can be dangerous. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Approved recommendation of Chaffer beetle. I integrated pest management of Chaffer beetle in grape using any soil based traps and cultural practices. So clean cultivation helps in reducing the beetle population. In all the we have seen in all fruit fly traps, clean cultivation is the backbone of the orchard. So this must be kept in all the when we use the traps, clean cultivation is must. So plowing around the trees during winter helps to expose and kill the hibernating pupae and adult. Birds also feed on exposed pupae and adults. So this is very beneficial. Irrigate the orchard as per recommended schedule, as it prevents the beetle from egg laying and also kills grubs and adults of the beetle. Fix any soil based traps. So here 12 traps per acre at ground level during last week of April for mass trapping of adult Chaffer beetle. Suck the sap from this trunk and from fruits, from leaves, and very much so in citrus. So you can see activity period is July to October. You can see on right side how it damage the plant, damage leaves, tender shoots, twigs, branches, and fruits. Suck the cell sap and reduce vigor, drying up of tender shoots and growing point, growth of shoothi mold on tissues. So this leads to the shoothi mold, which black layer is formed on the leaves, and which reduces photosynthesis and ultimately the plants bear no fruit. So shoothi mold, Jessica, you can see this. This on fruits and on leaves, blackish layer in guava. This is also very dangerous insect. So this is active in, during June to October. Some species are active in July to October. Neem suck cell sap from the leaves, tender shoot, twigs, branches, and fruits. Heavy infestation results in shoothi mold growth. Trees become black in color. Hibernation on twigs, branches, and shoots of trees. In grapes, actively period is July to October. So this damage on twigs, branches, leaves, and fruits. So other species damage on the tender shoots. So there are two different species of this mealybug. In papaya, this infestation. Papaya on the fruit, that was on first was on leaves, and this is on the fruit. So you can see the damage. So how to manage these mealybugs? Regular monitoring is very essential in orchards as well as in the kitchen garden. So proper sanitation is one of the funda which we use in all these eco-friendly approaches. So do not allow the branches to touch the ground. Prune and remove the infested branches. Destroy the adults. In mango, it's also very serious in mango. So suck the cell sap from inflorescence, panicles, tender leaves, shoots, and fruit pedicel. Active period is January to April. So pedicel shrivel and get dried. Shooty mold growth on infected tissue, that is blackish layer on the leaves. First, nymphs are after hatching from eggs in soil, migrate and crawl up to the mango trees and congregate on the growing shoots and panicle. Fertilized female hide in cracks and crevices and lays egg in the oocysts. So this is mango mealybug. So you can see in right side climbing on the tree. How to manage these mealybugs in mango? dig or plow around the mango tree during the summer or kill the eggs. This is very simple and cultural practices to manage the mealybugs. Prevent the nymph from crawling up on the trunk, slippery plant at the base in mid of December, May, December month should be placed. Slippery band 50 to 20 widen ulkathin sheet should be wrapped on the trunk. Secure both its upper and lower edges with 1, 2, 3 nails, 2 centimeter, so that they can get stick with the trunk. Cover the lower end with compacted soil to prevent nymphs from climbing up uppers under the slippery band. So this should be tightly done. Occasionally wipe the band during rainy season or other seasons so that the excreta of that mealybug should be clean from that slippery band. So citrus scilla and aphids are also two serious insects for citrus species. This is citrus scilla. So this is aphids. You can see the how they damage and leaf come curl, and shooty mold is also on the leaves. So for management of these aphids and nymphs, aphids and these scilla, horticulture mineral oil, which is eco-friendly management for citrus scilla and aphids. So spray about 6 liters of MAC HMO in 500 liter of 500 liter of water and sprayed on the infected plants. So there should not be, the one care should be taken that water stress not in the orchard. So orchard must be irrigated properly, and then the mineral oil should be sprayed. So white ant and thrips are also one of the major insects in these plants. So to manage these mechanical system, mechanically we can manage through applying yellow sticky traps of 6 into 11 inches. On right side of below you can see the sticky traps. This is nothing but only you can, these are available from market also, but for home management you can make yourself. You can take one of the slate or your some wooden or some iron piece of this 1 foot square, and you can place grease or some sticky material on that, and you can place these in your orchards or vegetable garden, and from somewhat raised from the ground, and these white flies and thrips stick on that. So after, when this is full of these white flies and thrips are sticked on that, you can wipe and again place the grease or Vaseline on that and place this in the field. So this work very efficiently and control many these thrips and white flies. So common, you can, now we are summing up with these. So common problems in practices in fruits which can be eco-friendly managed is a fruit drop in kinno. So during rainy season, this is very much seen. Some in the early season, this is the early months, it is naturally, but during rainy season it's on peak, and you can spray Bordeaux mixture 2 to 3 times. So copper oxychloride can also be used. If you can't make this Bordeaux mixture, which is very easy, so copper and this unslaked lime and water, these are mixed, and then Bordeaux mixture is prepared. Otherwise you can use copper oxychloride 3 grams per liter water. So this is also a eco-friendly approach. So fruit cracking, you see many fruits like Baramasi lemon and other fruits start cracking from its skin. So light irrigation at regular interval and water spray in the evening are very beneficial techniques to get rid from this fruit cracking. water stress not be taken in these fruits, and regular and light irrigation should be applied, and only simple water spray when sunset. After 1 hour, you can only spray the shower of water on the plants, and this you can minimize the fruit cracking problem. So mango malformation that bunches in infested plants, you have seen the bunches are seen in the plants. So very easy method is to remove and burn the berry and the infected bunches every year. But care must be taken to burn or bury. This is must. You have not to. Burnt or bury in the pit, then you can get rid. If you regularly do this practices 1 to 2 year in small plants, then you can get rid from this mango malformation problem. So frost damage is very prevalent in winter season. Cover the plants with straw or perforated polythene. Market different shear, different thickness, so you can use these net in these fruit plants. So collar rot, avoid the excessive irrigation. So this this helps in getting rid of this collar rot, which is a wilting of fruits like problem. So weeds, regular manual hoeing and mulching with paddy straw or plastic mulch is very beneficial in to controlling the weed problem. Irrigation, judicious use of water is very helpful in managing these insect pests and diseases. So every drop of water used with precision as per need become weapon against disease and pests. So this is very important in fruit plants. So when we talk about vegetables, there are some natural ways which we can practice in our kitchen garden or otherwise in fields also. These are given very good results. So balanced nutrition and judicious use of water is helpful in controlling insect pests and diseases. It is very necessary to use these practices. So irrigation very important in all these fruits and vegetables. So fruit fly, like fruit fly traps in fruits, in vegetables, in cucurbits, you can apply. There is another lure which can be used. 16 fruit vegetable fruit fly traps per acre can be used for cucurbits to minimize the effect of fruit flies. So to control sucking insects, yellow sticky trap. We have seen lastly in fruits, 6 into 11 inch size should be placed in field to control white fly, thrips, and other sucking insects. So virus diseases can be controlled by using 1 liter of cow urine plus 1 liter of milk mixed in 15 liter of water, and this will act as antivirus remedy. So various insect pests can be controlled with the mixture of 2 kg garlic, 1 kg ginger, and 1 kg green chili. These should be grind in mixie and mix these this material in 14 liter of water, sieve it and filter it with sieve and spray on the various vegetable. This controls the various insect pests in our in a natural way. So red pumpkin beetle, now you see this is a time when we have sown the cucurbits in month of February, March. So little when on small leaves they we see the cuts in the morning. So very our very old practices was that dusting of 1 kg cow dung cake ash mixed with 20 ml of kerosene oil. If kerosene oil is not available, you can use diesel. So in this ratio, and this should be spread on in the morning on the wet leaves, moist leaves, and this controls red pumpkin beetle. This makes layer on the leaves, and our leaves are protected from attack of red pumpkin beetle. So growth promoter, cow old, this cow dung cake is very good growth promoter. You can put 3 1-year old cow dung cake in 10 liter of water for 4 days in shade. Dip it in water for 10 liter and keep it in the shade for 4 days. Sieve the liquid through cloth and use. So 2 liter in 15 liter of water can be used. Then this is excellent growth promoter and in the vegetables. So neem, very beneficial plant. So 1 kg of neem leaves, put in 20 liter of water and boil it. Take the extract from after cooling. You can add 200 grams of gourd in that jaggery and spray. So neem kernel and seed extract are also very beneficial in this all practices. So these are some ways, natural ways, which can be used in vegetables. So this is the benefits from these all which we have done. So this all will, these eco-friendly techniques will maximize our crop production, which we already discussed in objectives also. Maximize the crop production with minimum input cost, minimize the environmental pollution in soil, water and air due to pesticide, minimize occupational health hazards due to chemical pesticide, preserve our ecosystem and maintain ecological equilibrium, conserve and protect ecosystem and environment, minimize the use of chemical pesticide and promote the use of bioagent, improve our farming system and save our natural resources too. Financial resources, natural resources too. So thank you very much. So again, reminding you that this is International Year of Fruits and Vegetables. So we have to contribute in this and have to practice these techniques in our field, in our kitchen garden, and get rid of these hazardous chemicals. So thank you very much.
Hello.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon, all. On behalf of Sri Sai Group of Institutes, Badhani Pathankot, and with the collaboration of Agriculture Science Department of Sri Sai Iqbal College of Management and Information Technology, Dr. Hoodal, this was a very nice session, and now I request audience, if they have some queries, they may ask if they have. Otherwise, it was a very nice session. Please, audience, you have 1 minute to ask or text your questions or queries. If anybody have.
Sir, I want to say one thing regarding this.
Yes,
that really this is a very informative information was there, that under the present circumstances, when there is lot of use of chemical and they are causing the health hazard to the human beings. So no doubt it is a very good initiative Dr. Hoodal has made. Regarding this bio control of insect pests that also called in the recent terms, this is eco-friendly ways. But there is one apprehension is there, that it takes a lot of time, that we have to practice among the farmers, we have to advertise it among the farmers that they should adopt it. This is a very good method to control insect pests. This is our traditional method. This is our traditional method with which we can control these insect pests. But one thing is there that among the farmers it had to be advertised. And this is my just a suggestion to you, because you are in the extension side, you are in the actual having contact with the farmers. So this method should be advocated among them.
Yes, Dr. Rambal, very nice suggestion. We are doing already in the kitchen garden and even in orchards also. Getting motivation from this topic, I have now started to translate in the Punjabi and do one webinar for farmers, exclusive for farmers.
Good.
Yes.
Good. So I should say my special thanks to Dr. Hundal that he accepted my invitation, and on behalf of the SSIJI, this is my special thanks to Dr. Hundal. And this was a really very informative webinar. A lot of information we have gained, and every participant must have gained this. Okay, all. Thank you very much.
Hello, sir. Vinod, sir.
Yes.
I want to say something. If any opportunity provided us by the Department of Horticulture Department to integrate with us and Horticulture Department, we are happy to work with them. We can adopt any village or adopt any area in which we can give our services under Udan, जो प्रधानमंत्री अपना ग्राम विकास योजना के अंतर्गत कोई भी काम हो तो हम किसी भी गांव को लेकर उसमें कॉलेज की तरफ से अपना कुछ जो भी हम पार्ट दे पाएंगे हम इच्छुक हैं उसके, और यदि हमें ये अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलेगी तो हमें बड़ी खुशी होगी कि सर हमें कोई मौका दें, और हमारे बच्चे भी उससे सीखेंगे, फैकल्टी भी सीखेगी, और जो एग्रीकल्चर का जो फर्टर्निटी है, जो साइंटिस्ट हैं, जो वर्कर्स हैं, और हम भी जानेंगे और वो भी जानेंगे कि एजुकेशन में और जो रियलिटी में वर्क हो रहा है वो कितना गैप है या उसमें क्या क्या रिक्वायरमेंट है।
Really, it's a very good suggestion our vice principal has given, and I will get in contact with Dr. Hundal regarding your suggestion.
Yes, Dr. Rambal, you can contact our local officers in
Patan. Yes, Mr. Jitendra is there.
You can also contact with the Krishi Gyan Kendra at.
Krishi Gyan Kendra is at Koh.
That is at Koh.
Yes, I know it. Yes. I will certainly
get that. Make any program and adopt your village, and must practice these techniques we have discussed.
Right, sir. Right. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Once again, I want to thanks to Dr. Sukhdeep Singh Hundal ji and his department and all his colleagues and department members to joining with us. And our faculty members and our students, I again thanks to all the audience and for giving such a nice information. And again, overuse of pesticide may affect the adversely to human being and nature also. And we are seeing in the environment nowadays what are the crises are in India. So thank you, sir. Thank you for providing us or giving us such a beautiful and informative information. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.